Hello and welcome to OptinMonster. We make it easy to create inline campaigns that you can place in blog posts, within content sections, or in your sidebar. In this video, I'll show you how to create an inline campaign. If you haven't done so already, be sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell. Now, let's get started. On the OptinMonster campaign dashboard, click Create New Campaign. To create a custom campaign completely from scratch, you can select the Canvas option. But for our purposes today, I'll select a campaign from our pre-designed template library. Select the inline campaign type. Next, browse the templates and select the template you'd like to use. You can click Preview to see an example, or click Use Template to select it. Type a name and select the website where you want the campaign to appear, and then click Start Building. In the Builder, customize your design as much or as little as you'd like. Be sure to check out our documentation on creating your first campaign for complete details. I've left a link in the description. When you're finished editing the campaign's design, click Save in the top right corner. Since the goal of this campaign is to build an email list, I'll need to connect my email service provider. To do so, head over to Integrations. Click Add New Integration and select your provider from the menu. OptinMonster integrates with over 30 of the most popular email providers on the market. Many of these simply require entering an API key that can easily be found from your email provider's dashboard. But what if you don't have a provider, or you want to create a backup list for added security? For that, you can select Monster Leads from the menu. This will store your contacts in your OptinMonster account. Many of our customers connect with their email service provider and Monster Leads at the same time. This sends their leads directly to their email provider so they can automate their email marketing strategy. But they also have a backup list stored with OptinMonster, just in case. Next, head over to Publish, and under Publish Status, select Publish. Since inline campaigns are different from pop-up style campaigns, which are targeted to different pages using display rules, you'll need to manually add your inline campaign to the page where you want it to appear. And this process will vary depending on the web platform you're using and where you want the campaigns to display. But fear not, we've got you covered. Simply follow the instructions in our documentation on how to manually add an inline campaign. I've left a link in the description. Or, for further assistance, you can submit a support ticket, and we'd be happy to help.